Hello everybody and welcome to part two of my album spotlight features for this week. I'm featuring different solo Beatles albums. Yesterday I focused on George Harrison's All Things Must Pass, which is fantastic. I really love that album, so please check out that spotlight. And today I'm talking about John Lennon and his album Plastic Ono Band. This is his debut solo studio album post-Beatles. This came out in late 1970, and it looks like it was released at the same time as a similarly titled album by his wife Yoko Ono, so she also has kind of her version of this. But it's pretty interesting album that I want to get into and talk about. As I talked about in the George Harrison video, I really am a Beatles fanatic. I really love all of their work and just am such a fan, but I've never really delved too far into the solo material after the Beatles broke up. And so that's kind of what I've been trying to do this past month or so, is kind of pick up on these materials and pick out some of the notable albums that people kind of hail as some of the landmark albums of the Beatles solo catalog. So to me, this was one that stood out that a lot of people talk about highly, Plastic Ono Band. And I actually got the record here that I want to showcase a bit. This is the newest reissue of it, which I believe came out earlier this year, if I'm correct. So definitely wanted to get this. Getting attacked by the big poster here that's part of the packaging. Inside, of course, you got this kind of gatefold here, kind of a childhood photo, and you know, just the typical album inside, you know, nothing too like fancy or crazy, but you know, just a cool sleek packaging. This is kind of a 2 LP version because it has some bonus material on the second LP. Of course, the main LP is just on one album, two sides, so that's mainly what I'm going to be focusing on in this little quick spot album spotlight. What happened in kind of the lead up to this album is that John Lennon and Yoko Ono went through some what they call primal therapy with the guidance of Arthur Janov for 4 weeks in his London offices. Those kind of therapy sessions seem to have inspired these albums that came out, one from John Lennon, one from Yoko Ono, about how they kind of are dealing with some of their issues and some of the things that they're dealing with problems in the world that they're facing and problems, you know, things that scarring them from their childhood and so forth. So it's really kind of an album of catharsis, of really dealing with some of these personal issues that John Lennon had at the time. And so because of that, it's a very raw, emotional album. And to be honest, as much as I appreciate the style here and what he's going for, and I respect him as an artist and really see the value here, you know, sometimes I have to separate what I enjoy listening to and what I respect as really valuable art, as it were. And I know a lot of people totally love this album, but it's really sonically just not my favorite of the post-Beatles era, because it's so sparse and minimal and parts of it are so harsh and you know, really digging deep into this emotional place that is a little bit difficult for me to listen to at times. For example, the opening track Mother, you know, it starts out kind of slower and contemplative, but it gets more intense, and towards the end he's like kind of screaming the lyrics, which, you know, showcases the emotion. You know, this is of course talking about kind of his abandonment issues with his parents, and specifically his mother, who he had a good relationship with apparently when he was younger, but she was killed in a car accident in 1958. So he was kind of abandoned by his parents, and that's kind of what he's talking about here. You know, there's kind of an opening funeral bell that begins the song, and it's kind of this repeating phrase, Mama don't go, Daddy come home, just really showcases those primal emotions that he's having at this time. And sometimes it's a little bit harsh and grating, but on purpose as part of the art. Hold On is kind of a cool contrast after that song, more of a laid back vibe to it. I'd say kind of more of a upbeat feel, kind of just having to hold on. to what's going on amongst all the kind of the craziness in the world, and in your own mind you try to hold on to what's good, you know, and try to hold on to this idea that everything's going to be all right in the end, you know, even though you're dealing with this harsh stuff in life. I found out is a fine basic rocker that kind of precedes. Working Class Hero is maybe my favorite track of the album. It's just a really personal song with just kind of voice and an acoustic guitar, kind of almost in the style of like a Bob Dylan or one of those kind of folky kind of singer-songwriters. It's very political and giving very pointed commentary about the difference between social classes. And, you know, of course, it has kind of that very honest and acerbic quality to it. But I think it's really an important song, and I think it's really well-crafted and important. So Isolation kind of inside one as more of a bluesy little piano and voice number, kind of sad, of course, dealing with that isolation and kind of being separated and feeling a little bit vulnerable and alone. So once again, kind of John Lennon dealing with his breakup with the Beatles and how that kind of brought him into this isolated place. And of course, the kind of attacks that him and Yoko got, you know, of course, Yoko is kind of credited with breaking up the Beatles, which, of course, unfairly, and got a lot of hate for that. But, you know, so that kind of deals with their isolation and their feelings behind that. Remember starts outside too, kind of some singing over piano riff, dealing with remembering things from his past, you know, even unpleasant things in his past, as part of the therapy. Love is a nice song, very simple and beautiful. It's kind of to me like this album's version of Imagine, maybe a different vibe to it than that, but kind of similarly arranged and presented. Really like this as a track. I think it's really strong. Well is another good strong rocking track, but it kind of leads to more screaming ish vocals and kind of a blistering guitar, you know, another kind of heavier kind of raw track. Look at Me is really pleasant. It kind of reminds of kind of the White Album and some of those tracks like Dear Prudence, Julia, Happiness is a Warm Gun. Kind of has that cool acoustic guitar picking style that's present in those songs. To me, the main ending song is God here, kind of a classic song where he's talking about what he doesn't believe in and what he does believe in, you know, talking about his belief system and how he kind of rejects a lot of these different belief systems, but what he just believes in is himself and Yoko, basically. And you can only really believe in yourself at the end of the day. So kind of a smaller track tacked on to the end, My Mummy's Dead, kind of a almost nursery rhyme quality, just kind of with the monotone vocals and maybe a chilling look at kind of his issues again with dealing with the loss of his mom and loss of his parents. So that's kind of the album. So once again, I have mixed feelings a little bit about the album. I respect it as a piece of art. I think it's really well crafted. I think it's an important album that talks about a lot of notable issues, deals with a lot of important personal subjects, and is probably a great piece to look at to kind of get into the mindset of John Lennon after the Beatles broke up. So as a piece of history, I think it's really important. But personally, you know, I think there's other John Lennon albums that I prefer. I like his later work. The album that stood out to me, maybe it's a little bit not regarded as maybe his best work. I don't even know how it's regarded, but I really loved Walls and Bridges from 1974. I thought that was just such an incredible album. I, you know, of course, Number Nine Dream is a very famous, incredible song in his catalog, maybe my favorite solo song of his, but just every track was just really pleasant. A lot of different vibes, some more upbeat stuff, some more introspective things, just really runs the gamut and just is a really great snapshot of that time period, I think, in music. So I really love that one. If I was to pick my favorite John Lennon album, that would probably be the one I'd lean towards. But I know that this one is widely regarded as a classic, the Plastic Ono Band. I think it's great for what it is and an important piece of art and an important kind of note in the story of John Lennon and where he's headed and where his mind was at. So that's what I have for today. So please check out my album Spotlight tomorrow. I'm going to cover Paul McCartney and what I think is considered widely his best album. Yesterday I talked about George Harrison, All Things Must Pass, which I really love. And so hopefully you're interested in kind of this, you know, solo Beatles exploration that I'm trying to do here. Please give your thoughts on John Lennon and his solo work in the comments. Maybe you guys like this album more than I do, but I'd be curious to hear kind of the thoughts about it and about his solo career. Like I kind of mentioned in the George Harrison video, I'm kind of slowly compiling a greatest Beatles solo playlist that I'll link in the description. And so I would be happy to add any other John Lennon songs that may be missing. So please post, comment your favorite John Lennon songs as well. And so that's about it for today's video. Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe if you like what I do here. Please keep enjoying any music that you are listening to. That's what it's all about here, is just having love for music and sharing it. That's really what I care about. So thank you guys so much, and I'll see you guys hopefully in the next one. Bye.